Hey YouTubers, this is Jeromex. So today is a slow Saturday, so I decided to service my Hina Mini Miraflex 2 direct ophthalmoscope. It's been standing in the cabinet for a while. So what happened was the battery compartment has been eroded with unused batteries. So first thing you need to do is to unscrew the cap, and I use some baking soda to remove the deposits, and I use a small toothbrush, and if it's resistant I use some sandpaper, and then I use my ultrasonic cleaner to clean the part. It would be great if you have this device. So you use some distilled water and a little soap to clean it. You also need a small set of screwdrivers and some rags and some Q-tips. And the first thing after you remove this, if the head is kind of dusty and full of gunk, you might want to take it apart. So there is actually no video on how to take this apart, so that's why I'm doing this video for the rest of those who like to attempt to service this device on their own. After removing the two small screwdrivers on the top and the bottom, you need to do that. Otherwise, if you just remove one, you still end up removing it when you, after you disassemble it, you still need to replace those two small screwdrivers back anyways. So might as well remove it. So you pry it open gently. There's actually a thing here which locks the device, so you sort of like slide it and then pry it open. Don't be surprised when you pry it open, there are two set of ball bearings will just fall apart no matter what you do. So first thing you need to remove is the wheel that rotates and changes the red free light, the whole light, and the half circle. So I wash it with water. Of course, you remove the bulb, first thing you do, and you remove the diopter knob control. So situate that when you return it, the numbers actually stay at the bottom. And I washed this earlier with soap and water, and I did an ultrasonic cleaner as well. And this thing too, this is just a holder which keeps the lens in place. This one, so if you can see that, it's hard to do a video with just one hand and one other hand using it. So just basically those are the parts, and you have some spring you have a couple of springs as well. You have a spring holds, there are two sets of springs. Let me get the, so a spring, it's hard to see, there's a two sets of spring and two sets of ball bearings. Each goes to the right one, otherwise if you change it, it's not gonna work fine. See the diameter of the big one and the small one, you can see it right there. So I washed the following. You wash this head and don't remove the magnifying light there, and this is sort of like the beam lens which focuses the light to the direct ophthalmoscope. So this is part two of where I left off, because I'm using an iPhone, so videotaping is kind of limited in terms of recording. So going back, I don't know where I left off was, this is the head already taken apart. You might be flabbergasted on the number of parts. All you have is this is the bigger spring with the ball bearing that matches the size, and the smaller, and the other smaller one with the smaller ball bearing. These are the two screw that holds the lens housing and the bulb and the wheel that rotates for the red free light and the other modes for the ophthalmoscope. This is also the head taken apart, and as well as the diopter control. So putting it back, the first thing you need to do, of course, after you clean it with soap and water, and I use the ultrasonic cleaner just like this, and you add distilled water here. Run it for 2 or 3 minutes, and putting it back, first thing you need to do is to put this wheel with the diopter wheel with the numbers going down like so. So next thing you need to do is to put the lens for the light in place into this housing like so, and the bigger spring to this slot here. It's kind of difficult to do repair with one hand here. You put this ball bearing inside, and the wheel, see to it that the metal part is the one that's facing the ball bearing. So I may have to do this first, and I'll show you what's done like so. So as you can see now, it's back in place. The ball bearing, the wheel. The next thing you know is to insert the light, the lens assembly here, like so. I really need both hands for this step right here, like so. So you can see that, and put the smaller spring here as well as the ball, and the diopter knob like so. As you can see, it's difficult to do this with just an iPhone, but basically that's how you do it. And last thing you do is insert the other end. Like this. As you can see there, I've already put the whole thing back, you can see. And next step is to just put the screw back. So it's pretty much it. Thanks for watching. Oh yeah, I would just have to prove to you that this thing works. With this screw, put the bulb back in place, put the bulb back so everything's back, and put the head back in place, put the battery. Final door is to test it, so you can see that it's able to fix it. See the red free light and the whole light, so it's good as new. As you can see there, alright, thanks for watching. Hope your works, and if you have a question about the disassembly, give me an email. Thank you.